to the ball game. Take me out with the crowd.
Buy me some peanuts and Cracker Jack.
I don't care if we never get back.
Let me root, root, root for the home team. If they don't win, it's a shame. So it's one, two, three strikes, you're out at the Oval.
Who will lead all the youngsters in the traditional Little League pledge before they get all wet.
Okay, boys, if you'll repeat after me the Little League pledge. I trust in God. I love my country and will respect its laws. I will play fair and strive to win. But win or lose, I will always do my best. Now the national anthem.
Oh, I know it.
Little technical difficulties with our national anthem, and we'll have that for you in just a moment.
We'll try it again.
Those fans lined up on this on the foul line. Here we go. Teams back to the dugout. The Moose team will be up first in tonight's ball game, and the Moose lineup, Dave, if you will.
Okay, for the lineup for the Moose team, we have at left field Chris Corcoran wearing jersey number 13. The pitcher for tonight's Moose team will be Mike Lacko. Shortstop will be Mark Miller. Third base played by Dana Walker. First base Tim Johnson. Randy Clark will be at right field. Kevin Larrison at center field. Mark Ambrosoni at second base, and catcher will be Alan Gleason.
Thank you. Dave Adams, helping me out this evening, doing a fine job so far. Dave, field conditions are questionable, but they are go. The ruling we have from the league president is they go as long as they can, they go as far as they can. If the managers agree the field is unplayable, they just pick it up wherever they leave off on Sunday afternoon. We want to run down the field for the Landos Woolbridge Hotel, who will be defending in the here at the top half of the first inning. The pitcher, the starting pitcher, is Mike Denise, number 15. Behind the plate, Kevin Brucey, number 12. Tom Sweet over at first. Derek O'Brien at second. Dwight Meifelt, the third baseman, at the hot corner, and at shortstop, Terry O'Brien. Around the outfield, Joe Dixon in left, Doug Raker in center, and Tom McClure over in right field. The umpire trying to make home plate visible. It's a little dirty at the moment. He's trying to wipe it off so that Denise can see it. And we'll be just about set for the umpire to yell, play ball. As we said, the game will start, and we hope to finish it for you. The rain is coming down rather constantly at, what would you call it, Dave, a medium rain at the moment?
Not a medium, yeah. Light drizzle to medium.
Okay. Right. It's a heavy drizzle, enough to get wet. Very good, Dave. But nevertheless, the play ball sign is just about to come out. And leading off for the Moose will be Chris Corcoran, the left fielder, wearing number 13. On deck will be Mike Lako, and in the hole, Mark Miller. Anybody that gets on, the cleanup hitter is Dana Walker. I can see Chris Corcoran taking his warm-up swings in the on-deck circle. I think everybody's ready as he approaches the plate. Denise is taking his warm-up pitches, and I think he needs some more warm-up pitches, Dave.
Yeah, he might need one more, maybe. A couple more. The first three or four look really good.
Kid's got a little mustard.
Uh-huh.
Weller and Dave Adams bringing you all the color and excitement of Little League Baseball from Elks Little League Park, right here on Corning's beautiful north side. The one strike pitch, cut on and missed, strike two. No balls and two strikes. And quickly, Denise ahead of Corcoran, nothing and two. As usual in Little League Baseball, a lot of pepper talk from the infield. The strike two pitch, strike three call, and back to the dugout goes Corcoran, strikeout number one for Denise. Three pitchers and there's one man away. Dave, this kid Denise looks like he's got his stuff tonight.
He looks like he's got him all right.
That brings up Mike Lako. Mike, the pitcher for Moose. There's a ground ball to short. Up with it is O'Brien over to Sweet, and not in time. The ball bounces in front of him. Lako heading for second, and he'll get there as the throw is a little bit late. And so, that was the ground ball to short. The throw to first was in the dirt. Sweet couldn't come up with it, and it got by him and over to second base on the play. Over to second on the play goes Lako, and that brings up Mark Miller. I'll wait for a ruling from the score. The first pitch is inside for a ball. Gets away from the catcher, Brucey, and over to third goes Lako. So Lako now on third. Official score, did we get a ruling on that first thing? Was that a straight error all the way? Two errors on the shortstop? All right. Outside, and the count goes to 2-0 to Mark Miller. The ruling on that hit by Lako was it? Two errors to the shortstop, one on the throw. Well, two base error on the throw, actually. One error against the shortstop. That's ball three to Mark Miller. Ball three to Mark Miller, and now it's 3-0. Mike Lako leading off third base. The 3-0 pitch, the bat on his shoulder, it's in there for a call strike. Miller taking all the way. Mark Miller wearing number 9, batting from the right side. He's the shortstop for the Moose Club. Denise into his windup. Here comes the pitch. Outside ball four, and Miller is on. And that puts runners at the corners with one gone for the Moose. And Kevin Brucey wants to go out and talk to his pitcher, Mike Denise. Meanwhile, Dana Walker coming up, the big third baseman for the Moose Club. And he looks like he's a solidly built kid. He waves the bat menacingly. Denise comes to the plate with the first pitch. Cut on and missed strike one. Breaking for second is Miller, and he gets there uncontested. Just walked over to second base, and Brucey faked the throw and didn't make it. Runners now on second and third with one gone. There's a pitch inside for a ball. That one really hummed in there, but he brushed him back, and the count goes to 1-1. Moose runners on second and third. One man out, top half of the first inning. Mike Denise comes to the belt to the plate, high and outside for ball two, and the count is now 2-1. There's one man out in the top of the first, and the Moose with a scoring opportunity. Runners, two runners in scoring position. By the way, the wind tonight is almost nil. The flag wrapped around the flagpole. There's a pitch way outside, and it's retrieved nicely by Kevin Brucey to stop any runners from advancing. And Denise headed for the plate immediately when he left the ball go. He knew it got away from him. Mike Denise, wearing number 15, over at the pitcher's mound, now finds himself behind 3-1 to the cleanup hitter, Dana Walker. He's got to come in with this one. There's a 3-1 pitch. Cut on a drive to left field. It's on, and it's over the fence on one bounce for a ground rule double. Coming in to score is Mike Lako along with Mark Miller. And Dana Walker is on at second base with a ground rule double. That one hit about 5 feet in front of the fence and just bounced over immediately. And the Moose are up 2-0. Dana Walker with a two-run double to left field. One bounce over the fence, and there's a cute little girl on the other side of the fence that is going to retrieve the ball. Of course, the umpire has a new one in his pocket, and one of those balls will come back into play. A two-run double for Dana Walker here in the top of the first inning has put the Moose on the scoreboard, and they lead 2-0. And that brings up Tim Johnson, number 10, the first baseman.
Time out, there's a ball on the field.
There's an extra ball on the field. The one that was hit over the fence just came back with the help of a few nice fans. And so, a momentary timeout. Now Denise is ready, and so is Johnson. There's the pitch. High for a ball, one ball and no strikes. On second base with that double is Dana Walker. Two runs batted in for Dana. And at the plate, Tim Johnson. The one ball pitch, cut on, a drive to right center field, going for it with a beautiful catch is Doug Raker. Raker off with a crack of the bat to his left, and he came up with that hard line drive off the bat of Tim Johnson. And that's the second man out in the bottom half of the first, and that'll bring up Randy Clark, the right fielder.